Hello and welcome to All Things Antares. My name is Mark Silverstein. In this episode, we're going to discuss the all-new Antares 44 hybrid. We're going to walk through in detail what a parallel hybrid system is. We're going to show you how a parallel system hybrid works on the water. And finally, we're going to give you some of the key benefits of a parallel hybrid system for someone that wants to cruise around the world, see very, very remote places, and do it as economically and as efficiently as possible with a hybrid system. Okay, so let's talk about the parallel system and the key components so that we can at least explain how it works and why these components are critical. First of all, let's talk about propulsion. So we have, like we normally have on any other Antares, two Yanmar 40 horsepower diesel engines. So that's a key part of the hybrid solution. We still have diesel engines to propel the boat. Second of all, in parallel to that diesel engine, we have two 10 kilowatt electric motors. And these motors sit on top, think about this, they sit on top in parallel with a belt that will turn and spin that shaft. So we have the ability in this scenario, that's why it's called parallel, I can run one side of the boat on electric only, I can run the other side on diesel, or both diesel, both electric, and flip those back and forth, it doesn't matter. And that's one of the beauties of a parallel system. So second of all, you need to also have a clutch installed in this environment. And the reason for the clutch, and you can see the clutch in the video, the reason for the clutch is if you're at anchor and you want to turn on and utilize that 10 kilowatt motor, which is also a 6 kilowatt generator to generate power for your boat, you need the clutch to disengage that shaft so that you can still run the engine and charge in total 12 kilowatts back to the house bank while you're at anchor. So that's what the clutch provides and does in this design. So we're now going to go through and talk about the control box, the brains behind the system. Think about it like this. If you're drawing current from a house bank battery and you don't want to go below, in this case, let's say 80% depth of discharge for a lithium battery bank, you need to have some way of controlling that. You don't want the motors to continually drawing power and drain your batteries down to zero. In addition, when you're charging and using that generator, you don't want a shock load on that engine of from 0 to 6 kilowatts just in a second. So this control box is the brains behind the hybrid system. This control box will slowly ramp up the charge, and you'll see that in the demonstration. And it will also control not overcharging. As you get close to fully charged, it will slowly decrease the amount of current going to those batteries to keep your batteries in good health. It provides communication to you at the helm on the status of your batteries from your Victron BMS systems. And it's the critical part behind the entire environment. So now we've talked about the engines and the electric motors, and we need power to that. And so that's where the Victron, the 40 kilowatts of Victron batteries come into play. So as standard on the Antares Hybrid, we have 40 kilowatts of Victron lithium. And we also have standardized with all of the key components to be Victron on the boat. And the reason for that is we feel like Victron has done a very good job on integrating their systems to talk to each other, whether it be the inverter, whether it be the solar controllers, whether it be the BMS, making sure all the batteries are okay and you don't have any runaway cells in your battery bank. Everything just talks and works together. And we want to keep things as safe and as simple as possible on our boats. Let's now turn this over to our special guest, Graham. Graham is the CEO of Hybrid Marine, and he has been down in Argentina for a week with myself and the entire team commissioning our first hybrid. And I'm going to have Graham give you a deep dive on how this system works and show you firsthand the Antares Hybrid on the water.
Hello there, I'm Graham from Hybrid Marine, and I'm here to give you a quick overview of how the hybrid system functions. I've got a beautiful dashboard here in front of us, the B&G instruments, then we have the Yanmar engine panels, and then the hybrid control panels. So here, this is the view you'll get when you first turn the system on. So that as default, you're powered up and the hybrid is disabled at the beginning. So a few features here, this is our battery button here. Press that. That gives us our overall battery parameters. So we have a data connection to the Victron lithium-ion batteries, and it's telling us here they're at 78% state of charge, 52 volts, and the current consumption is about minus 35 amps. I think we've got the aircon going, that's why. Then there's these little fields here, that's charge enable and discharge enable. So this is a safety feature for the system. If the batteries are near full charge, then we'll disable the charge enable. If the batteries are running down to being too low, then we disable the discharge enable. And so that's a function of the system there. So what we'll do now is we'll go back to the main display here. There we go. And so, get that. Right, so to enable the system, it's the second button, which is the propeller that's greyed out. You press that for 2 seconds, and it springs into action. Same here, 2 seconds, spring into action. So that's showing us one electric drive on both sides. So we have a throttle indicator here, forward and reverse. We have the state of charge here coming from the lithium batteries, and right now we're in neutral. So it's just as simple as putting them to gear, give a bit of forward drive. So there we are on forward electric drive. This is telling you the current drawn from both sides here. And our icon here is moved in the forward direction. If we don't want to go reverse, then we go reverse here. And this is the reverse happens. So it's quite as simple as that for operating electric. Let's say now we want to pull the anchor up and come off the anchor. So one really good feature here is we can enable the radio mode. Yeah, hold it. And the same here. So now we have this radio control here, as you can see, and this gives us a thrust in forward and reverse. So if you press this side here, see the forward goes forward thrust, press the bottom button, goes into reverse. And likewise on the starboard side, forward and reverse. So with that control there, that means when you're anchoring or coming off the anchor, you can drive the boat forward and backwards and help set the anchor or drive it over to help pull it up again. That's quite a nice little feature. So then we'll go back to electric drive here. Just re-enable electric. So there we're in electric drive again. Now let's say our batteries are running down, or maybe the conditions are quite a bit more severe, so you need a bit more grunt than the electric motors can give. So to do that, move into neutral, we enable the Yanmar engine panels. They'll take an age to fire up, but let's just start the engines. There's the engine started. We're in idle mode here. When we put her into gear, the driver forward. Jackie on the dock. Now we go into charging mode. And at moderate cruising speeds, this will ramp up to approximately 100 amps per side. So let's do this side here. Let's get that going. Right, so I'm going to show you a few of the safety features here. If we go back to the battery monitor here. So we're now in electric drive. We're at 78% state of charge, and the lithium batteries are telling us that discharge and charge are both enabled. As we run down, it's right set now to 20% threshold. When we come down towards 20%, you've got to think about not discharging the batteries beyond that, although that is a threshold that you can program in the system. So it means at 5% before that, at 25%, it starts cutting back the power to the electric drive, and it gradually does that for a 5% range until it gets down to the program threshold of, say, 20%, and then the hybrid cuts off, and it prevents the batteries being overdrained. And in the same way, when we're on charging, we'll enable charge until we get close to full charge, and when we do get close, we then will cut back the charging power and then disable completely, set now at 95%. So the way it's set now, it can run between 95% and 20% range on the batteries. Apart from that, there are also signals directly from the battery management unit that also we will respond to if they decide there's an internal fault, perhaps an over temperature or maybe an over voltage cell would also cut the system off. Another feature here I'll show you for safety. Let's go back to neutral. Let's turn everything off. Back to the monitor here. Let's say someone's put it in gear while we're stationary, and now we enable the hybrid. Yeah. It's not going to shoot off, but it's telling us here we need to put into neutral. So put into neutral here, and neutral there. It will reset itself, and now you can go into drive. And then finally, once you've finished the day, because there's no noise from the motors, you're not warned that they're active, you would go back to the screen here and switch the system off with this button here and this button here. And although it's turned off, you can still see the battery monitor for the Victron cells. Hi there, so here's our parallel hybrid system. This is a Yanmar 3JH40 diesel engine here with a standard marine gearbox connected to the drive shaft. Then our electric motor comes on top of that and connects also to the drive shaft in parallel with the engine, hence parallel hybrid. So the modes of operation can be with the engine turned off, we can use the electric motor. That's rated at 10 kilowatts or about 12 horsepower. So plenty of power there for normal, sort of calm cruising conditions. But when the going gets tough, then you will be back on the engine then to get this full 40 horsepower for you. So some features here. First of all, in front, just to the rear of the engine here, we have what we call the shaft clutch. So that's just down here. Yep. And that's not normally engaged during when you're sailing the boat. It's just that if you're in an anchorage and you're short of power and you want to run this as a generator without turning the propeller, then you would disconnect that shaft clutch. There's a lever just in here that operates it to open and close it.
Still being installed, but soon. Yeah.
Yes, still installed. So that's the purpose of the shaft clutch, but in normal operation, that's closed all the time. Then we have back here, this little red thing. This is a shaft lock. And what this is you can let the propeller freewheel and regenerate power from the hybrid while you're under sail. And typically at 7.5 to 8 knots, you should get 0.5 kilowatt per shaft. So you can regenerate about 1 kilowatt or 24 kilowatt hours a day. So when your batteries are full, if you're not using that amount of energy, you probably want to stop propeller spinning. And that's the idea of this shaft lock here. So there's a button again in the cupboard here, you press that would lock the shaft and stop it freewheeling when it's not in use.
And Graham, talk about that belt, what it's for.
Okay.
It's not in the right place yet. But
yeah, this here, this is a spur drive belt. So there's a drive belt from the motor to the pulley that's on the output shaft of the gearbox. If that was to break, and what breaks belts is shock impact. If it hits a log or you're back onto a reef or something like that, you can break a belt. So the idea is there's a spur belt already around the shaft here, which means you don't have to be decoupling a shaft to replace it.
and that means you can probably swap a belt out in 10 or 15 minutes.
Perfect. And how about the stainless steel Hybrid Marine logo? What is this device there for yeah. exactly?
Okay, so this is it's not actually an air filter. Yamaha don't have filters on the input. They have an air box, and that's a small expansion chamber. And the original one was too big to use because the motor gets in its way. So we came up with a custom developed air box that's a little bit shorter, and got a Hybrid Marine logo on the top of that.
Perfect. And that's all there is to it, right? The standard Yanmar, then with your Hybrid Marine components on the back, with the clutch that we have back there, and then the shaft. Now, the shaft lock is only needed for certain types of props, correct?
Yes.
Or
so
not?
Props that need to be stopped to stop them opening up. So like the auto prop, you have to lock it, otherwise it can start spinning again. Fetterman propeller, normally to get it stopped, you would lock the shaft. So it just depends on the type of propeller you have, whether you
okay.
want to do that.
So not every boat would have to have that. They had
correct. Not every yeah. prop would need that.
Right, not every prop would need that. Perfect. Thank you, Graham.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, Graham, very much for that demonstration and all the examples that you gave us. Let's now talk about the so what. What does this mean to the average person owning a hybrid? And I want to walk you through a scenario that's based on a lot of research that we did, myself included, in particular on the efficiency of solar panels. And let's just go through a typical average daily consumption on watts of what a typical cruiser could consume. Now, let me just caveat this. Different people run their boat in different ways. Some people will cook a lot more. Some people will use a lot more water. Some people will maybe want to run the AC less or more. But this is just simply an example based on real data that we've collected from our boats to show you what it is like living on a hybrid. So in general, nutshell, around 8.5 kilowatts would be consumed on a boat that is utilizing all electric for everything, including cooking. And you say, okay, well, what does that really mean? And how does that really apply to a 2 kilowatts, in this case it's 1.9 kilowatts, but 2 kilowatts of power on the boat? Well, it's important to understand a couple things. Number one, solar panel efficiency varies based on sun angle, and it also varies based on temperature, and it also varies based on the quality of those panels. So in our examples, we are talking about using the Panasonic HIT hard panels. They are far more efficient than a walk-on panel. One of the big reasons for that is temperature, because they have ventilation underneath those panels. And so we've done tests on this. We actually have on our hybrid a combination of hard panels as well as some of the Solara, which are the top of the line walk-on panels. And we do have a pretty good idea on the efficiency differences. And even though the cells themselves might be 22% as an example, you still, as the boat heats up, as the sun comes up, you will still have reduced efficiency on walk-on panels than you will on hard panels. That is why we choose on Antares to go the extra mile and the extra effort to put on hard panels where possible. It's not 100%, but it's where possible. So let's talk about this. So 1.9 kilowatts, this research was done by myself on my boat. I have these panels on my boat in the rainy and dry season. And let me just qualify that. We've been living between 15 degrees north and 15 degrees south. So we're in this latitude where we don't really have cyclones or typhoons or very many of them, especially not where we are right now. But we do have what's called rainy season, a lot rainier, and dry season, a lot more sun, a lot less rain. So on 1 month worth of analysis, with 1.9 kilowatts of Panasonic HIT on our boat, we get about 6.5 kilowatts a day on average of regeneration from solar, or 8.5 kilowatts roughly in the dry season. So if we look at the average consumption that we're projecting for the average boat per day, net-net in the rainy season, running the AC, this is a DC Maybrew AC unit, for 4 hours a day, that's 1.2 kilowatts of consumption, you will be able to operate your boat for 14 days without having to do a recharge. And that's down to 70% depth of discharge. If it's a dry season, you'll be able to operate your boat for 165 days with 1.9 kilowatts of solar. So that is a substantial amount of time. And so let's just ask the different question, and let's just say, what happens after the 14 days, how long will it take me to recharge my batteries if I need to flick on an engine? And the answer is pretty simple. It's math. We've got 12 kilowatts total of capable recharge, and we'll dial that down, and we're going to say that we can do, let's just say, 11 kilowatts total. That's five and a half kilowatts per side versus 6 kilowatts. End of the day, that's 10 kilowatts an hour, and at 70% depth of discharge in this example, it would take us 2.5 hours to recharge our batteries 100%, running both engines, and then we're off to the races again another 14 days in the rainy season. In the dry season, as I mentioned, it's a heck of a lot longer. So this just gives you an example of what it would be like to live on an Antares hybrid in these types of environments and give you some sort of a view of that. Now, something that I think is really exciting and probably sometimes underestimated when you start thinking about a hybrid is the hydro regeneration component. And this is something that's significant because even though you spend roughly 90% of your time at anchor, which most cruisers do, they sail, they stay, sail, stay, and then they usually stay somewhere for a week or two and they move on. I know that's been the case for us for the last 12 years. So let's talk about passage making. And this is something that I'm excited about because we have typically sailed a lot on our boat. Sometimes we will sail anywhere from 6 to 10,000 nautical miles in a year. And that's quite a bit of sailing, quite a bit of time underway. And we like to be able to still utilize AC units and utilize water makers and everything else. Well, the important part to think about here is the hydro regeneration. I'm going to use this example. Assume similar consumption, but you actually will consume more power when you're sailing than when you're not. And that's because of the autopilot. You're having your nav station, your chart plotters on full time, 24 hours a day. So you have a lot more power consumption, and this chart represents that. But the other key part of that is your solar. You have a lot of shading on your solar when you're sailing because of shadows from your sails. No matter what anyone tells you, it's going to happen. And so in this example, we are assuming a 50% reduction in solar efficiency while we're sailing due to shading. That's what this example is showing. And we're also assuming that even though we can generate 340 watts at 7 knots, we're going to even dial that down a little bit more, and we're going to say only 250 watts per side of hydro regeneration on 24-hour passage. So that's 500 watts an hour of regeneration. Well, in 24 hours, that will get us 12,000 or 12 kilowatts of power generated in one 24-hour period. So what does that mean? The bottom line is, what that means is we have anywhere from 3 to 4, 4.5 kilowatts of surplus power if we're burning through 11.5, 12 kilowatts a day on the boat while we're underway. So don't underestimate the hydro regeneration benefits when you're sailing the boat. Even though it may only be 10% of the time that you own the boat, you're sailing, the reality is it is substantial, and it can make your passage making even that much more comfortable, in particular, running the air conditioner. So that's a quick summary of the parallel hybrid from Antares. I hope it was beneficial to you. I would like to just point out that we will be doing a deep dive and talking more specifically about the difference between parallel and serial in a different video. So in conclusion, we are very happy to have our first hybrid on the water. We are thrilled all the effort that has taken place on the design of this product. We made the announcement over a year and a half ago publicly about our hybrid. It was 6 months in design prior to that, so it's been 2 years that we have been working on this hybrid solution. And I just want to thank everybody that's been involved with this, from our current customers who have really pushed us and pressed us to think outside the box. We're happy to see other boat manufacturers now starting to follow us down this path, in particular using parallel hybrid systems. We think, for many reasons, this is the best solution for a blue water cruising boat, and we look forward to talking and showing everyone a lot more in detail, you know, why this is the world's best liveaboard. Thank you very much for your time and attention.